Hi friends, welcome to Delicacies on the Plate. Today I am going to make chocolate truffle cake. First we will start up with sieving of the dry ingredients. So herein goes 200 grams of plain flour into the sieve. This is 1 tablespoon of baking powder and 1/2 tablespoon of baking soda added to the sieve. And herein goes 1 small bowl of cocoa powder, which is approx 5 tablespoons. Add it and sieve it. I'm going to sieve it twice so that all the dry ingredients mixes well. Before sieving it for the second time, first mix it with the help of the spoon and then sieve it again. This will help in making the cake more softer and fluffier. Once the dry ingredients are sieved, we will start up with the wet ingredients. In a mixing bowl, add in around 100 grams of butter. To this, add in 100 grams of powdered sugar and blend it with a hand blender till it becomes soft and fluffy. Use the butter at room temperature so that it mixes well and easily with the sugar. To this also add in 4 to 5 tablespoons of fresh cream. This will make the cake moist. Blend this too well into the butter and sugar mixture. Once all the wet ingredients are mixed well, keep it aside and proceed with the next step. In a cup, take around 125 ml of milk and add 1 teaspoon of coffee powder, instant coffee powder, and mix it. Coffee enhances the flavor of the chocolate, so this is an important ingredient while making the chocolate cake. In the mixing bowl, add in 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract. Now add in all the dry ingredients and wet ingredients and mix well. Mix them in batches so that you get a lump-free batter for the cake. Add little bit of coffee and now mix it by folding technique. So in this way, I'll mix in all the ingredients. Once one batch is done, I'll add the remaining of the dry ingredients and the coffee. So herein goes some more dry ingredient and little bit of coffee, and again mix it. Now here you can see the batter is ready. If you feel that the batter is a bit thick, you can add in 3 to 4 more tablespoons of milk and mix it well. Now herein I have the cake tin. In the base there is the parchment paper, I have buttered it. Now sprinkle some dry flour so that the cake doesn't stick to the pan. Dust the pan nicely with the plain flour and then add in the cake batter into it. Now spread the cake batter onto the sides, making the layer uniform. After making the top surface uniform, tap it for 2 to 3 times to get rid of any air bubble into the batter. And now then this is ready to go into the oven, which is preheated for 10 minutes on 180 degrees Celsius. Keep it on the center of the rack on the second shelf for 30 minutes. After 30 minutes, you can see the cake is ready. You can check it with a knife. If it comes out clean, that means that the cake is ready. Let it cool down for around 10 to 15 minutes and then unmold it into a plate. You can see here the cake is so soft and spongy. I will again invert it on the back of a plate wherein I'll be decorating the cake. First, I'll make the sugar syrup for it. So start to heat up a saucepan. Add in half bowl of water and half bowl of sugar to it and let it come to boil. After the sugar syrup comes to boil, switch off the flame and remove the sugar syrup into a bowl. Now herein, with the help of a thread, this is the plastic thread, I am going to slice in the cake. So just carefully slice in the cake in two equal parts. After slicing the cake, if you want, you can also remove the upper crust of the cake. So just carefully remove the upper crust. Slowly take off the upper layer onto another plate. To the lower layer, apply the sugar syrup with the help of the brush. This will make the cake moist. And then I'll spread the chocolate ganache, a layer of chocolate ganache onto this. Then I'll put back the second layer of the chocolate cake and then repeat the process. Apply the ganache spread on the sides too. Pop it up into the fridge so that the chocolate ganache sets nicely. Keep the cake into the fridge for at least 30 minutes so that the chocolate ganache sets well, and then repeat the process with the second layer. After finishing off with the second layer, again pop it up into the fridge for 30 minutes so that the chocolate ganache sets nicely, and then we will start off with the layering of the ganache glaze. So just slowly put the ganache glaze onto the cake. It will automatically spread on the sides. If any part is left over, with the help of the knife you can just cover that portion too. And the extra ganache glaze which flows out, you can collect it back again and reuse it. After you apply the ganache glaze onto the cake nicely, pop it up back into the fridge for 30 minutes and then start decorating it. On the sides, you can sprinkle some chocolate vermicellis. You can decorate the cake with chocolate whipping cream. Delicious chocolate truffle cake is ready. Enjoy your celebration with the chocolate truffle cake. If you have liked this video, don't forget to give a thumbs up, share it with your friends, and subscribe for more such delicious recipes on Delicacies on the Plate.